And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek Next Generation Final Unity Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. I wasn't sure what to do at the end of last episode or the second half of last episode. Sorry about that. I think we're supposed to talk to these gentlemen again. I'm not sure which one, so we'll just go in order, I guess. Why are you so interested in the fifth skull? Can we exit out? No. So apparently once I go into this, I have to...
Of course. Starfleet Command is still considering the options. While we review the situation, the Enterprise is to remain on patrol.
Sorry.
Got out. Why are you so interested in this fifth scroll?
I don't know how to quit out, so we'll just listen to him say it again, I guess.
I am a scholar, Captain. My interest is purely academic. Lucana, on the other hand, is a social revolutionary. She hopes the scroll will inflame the underclasses to rebellion.
How would an ancient scroll do her any good?
The patrician stopped the lawgiver before he could reveal his fifth scroll. The lawgiver and a few of his disciples, known as the followers, left Garrett in 5 spaceships to start their own colony.
Yeah, now that I think about it, I could have chose that other option too. You know, I'm busy right now, etc.
No trace of them. The story gradually took on mythic proportions. The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Garrett's history. Even if you don't agree with Lucana's goals, I urge you to talk to Shanok and help us find the scroll for science's sake.
This could be an intriguing quest.
Well, this is different. Let me talk to the others first. I'm gonna ultimately choose that.
If you'll excuse me, I have other duties to attend to.
Captain Picard, it is imperative that you help us find the lawgiver's fifth scroll.
We don't have the option to tell her that.
If you'll excuse me,
We can only tell Tabak.
Please, Captain. In the name of justice for an oppressed people, we need you to help us find the fifth scroll and bring it back to Garrett.
It's a white Afro man. Alright, let's talk to Tabak.
The fifth scroll could be the greatest.
I have decided to visit Shanok, etc.
I have decided to visit Shanok and see whether he can help you regarding the fifth scroll.
Shanok, whatever.
Thank you for agreeing to visit Shanok, Captain.
Potato.
The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Garrett's history.
Sounds exciting. Understood. Be underway at once, blah blah blah.
Understood. We will be underway at once. I will let you know when we arrive.
I'm so used to, when playing Mass Effect, reading the prompts of what he's going to say, because they usually say something different. And it's just a habit now, but it makes no sense for me to read the whole thing when Picard's just going to say the exact same thing.
Mr. Worf, inform Starfleet that we will be assisting the Garridians in their search.
Aye, sir.
Aye, sir.
Computer, what are the current whereabouts of the Vulcan archaeologist Shanok?
According to Federation Archaeological Survey records, Shanok is currently excavating ruins on the planet Horst 3.
Horst 3?
Set course for Horst 3, Warp 5.
Now don't screw that up. Don't go to Horst 5 at Warp 3. I mean, just do the way he said it.
Aye, sir.
Engage.
Go, it didn't crash. I meant the game, not the ship. Warp 5. Ooh, we're far away. Can we, like... What do we do in the meantime?
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we contact Starfleet.
We just did that.
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain.
Alright, tactical. What do I get into engineering? Computer. Engineering.
Raising shields.
Why do we automatically raise shields? Get the wrong thing. I'm not even sure. We're only 19 away now. We want, astrogation course. Ah, here it is. Warp 8, please.
Engage.
Just get a little quicker now. Is this all you do? You just sit around and wait for it, like, this is like more of like a simulation. You have to wait for it to arrive at the planet. Almost there. I realize the irony of being 2 light years away.
Helm, standard orbit.
That we're almost there. It's funny. All right. Well, there's Horst 3. Can we hail the planet? Yes. Shanok.
Greetings, Shanok. I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard.
Captain, how may I assist you?
Interesting background. What brings an archaeologist of your stature to such a remote planet? We have several Gridian refugees aboard who are trying to find something about the Fifth Scroll. Let's ask him what brings him here. Idle chit-chat before we get right to it.
What brings an archaeologist of your stature to such a remote planet?
I am excavating the ruins of a Chodak outpost. Hmm. The Federation Archaeological Survey is sponsoring my work.
A Chodak outpost? Can't say I've heard of them. Or that.
Who are the Chodak?
Well, there you go.
An ancient race. At their peak, the Chodak occupied most of what is now the Romulan Empire.
Really?
But I thought all known Chodak ruins were on the other side of the neutral zone.
This is the first Chodak site found in Federation space. It was my good fortune to discover it.
Hmm. What have you found so far?
What have you found so far?
Mm. A great deal, actually. I have uncovered evidence of an extensive administrative system, as well as examples of Chodak computer technology quite similar to our own isolinear rods.
Huh.
Intriguing. Such devices would be among the oldest known examples of isolinear technology in the galaxy.
Yeah, known now. Huh.
I hope to confirm that fact. I sent several rods to the Merton's orbital station for testing.
Ah.
They've developed a gravitic stress dating method which is extremely accurate. However, I have not yet received their results.
Yeah, they're a little busy. Guys, see episodes, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah, tell them the bad news.
I'm afraid we have got some bad news for you, Shanok. Merton's station has been attacked. It was almost completely destroyed.
Indeed. That is a great loss.
Great loss, loss, loss. I do want to check it out, but let's tell him about the Garidians.
Shanok, we have several Garidian refugees aboard who are trying to find something called the Fifth Scroll. They said you might be able to help.
Possibly. I once did extensive research on the Lawgiver and the followers. They fled into what is now Federation space 1,000 years ago, bearing the Fifth Scroll with them.
Hmm.
We've heard of them. So where did these followers go?
I never found the followers' colony, but your friends should not lose hope. In my search, I stumbled on one of the followers' ancient ships.
Cool.
The logs indicated that they had found an M-class planet suitable for colonization.
You imagine if Picard just went, cool. I'd be most eager to examine the site myself. I can beam down immediately.
I'd be most eager to examine the site myself. I can beam down immediately.
Sorry, guys. I'm used to reading the lines.
Captain, I'm aware of your reputation as an archaeologist, but I cannot permit any visitors. The excavation is far too delicate. My apologies.
That's quite all right.
Thank you for your help, Shanok. Good luck.
And to you, Captain. Live long and prosper.
And the same to you, Captain.
I should like to consider the situation a bit further.
Alright, didn't have a choice there. I guess we gotta speak to them. Tabak seemed to be the one who could make the decisions, I guess.
The fifth scroll could be the greatest social discovery in Garrett's history.
Yeah. Alright, never mind. Lucana?
Too long have we been the slaves of our patrician masters. We must find that fifth scroll to save my people from oppression.
Please, Captain. In the name of justice for an oppressed people, we...
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have any suggestions right now.
Oh, God, you're gonna leave me not knowing what to do again?
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest we...
Counselor, do you have any thoughts?
I'm sorry, Captain, but...
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain, we should check our orders from Starfleet.
I am gonna check with Starfleet. Let me check up with the Chancellor here.
Chancellor, the Vulcan archaeologist Shanok sent some artifacts to Merton's station to be tested. Can you give us any information about this?
I'm sorry. Shanok's artifacts were in the destroyed section of the station, as were many other relics we were analyzing.
No good.
Thank you again for your efforts, but I'm afraid we're rather busy. There's much work to do to recover from this disaster.
Admiral Williams here. What can I do for you, Captain?
Orders?
I'd like to confirm our current orders.
Of course. Starfleet Command is still con-
What is the current situation, Admiral?
Actually, things are relative.
Picard out.
So, what the hell are we supposed to be doing?
Captain.
Oh. I don't know what he said. I was clicking view screen. On screen.
On screen.
Whatever the hell.
Greetings, Admiral. What can we do for you?
Jean-Luc, good to see you again. I have a little favor to ask. Would you be interested in finding a little lost lamb for me?
Is your name Mary? A lamb?
A lamb?
A figure of speech.
Yeah.
I have a friend stationed on Morassia, an exobiologist. I haven't heard from her in quite a while. I'm getting a little worried. I'd like you to check into it if you can.
Okay, maybe we'll do that instead. Who's the lost lamb?
Who exactly is this lost lamb?
Her name is Dr. V. Hunforsch. She was on Morassia cataloging local species for the Federation Zoological Database, but no one's seen her for days.
Do not ask me to repeat that. I cannot say that. Hunforsch?
Have the local authorities investigated the matter?
Constable Lixie, who runs the preserve, thinks V went on a field trip and that there's nothing to worry about. To humor me, she said I should send a team to investigate.
Admiral, do you have any reason to suspect foul play?
The truth? V is headstrong, but she might be chasing butterflies. But I think there's more to it than that.
She isn't a virtual intelligence, is she?
And Jean-Luc. Morassia is applying for Federation membership. You could review the state of affairs there while you're looking for our exobiologist.
Okay. Very well.
Very well. As soon as we receive your report, we'll get on the way.
I'll transmit it immediately. Oh, and Jean-Luc.
Sounded familiar.
The Morassians have a strict matriarchal society. Males are usually treated as servants at best. Don't take it personally.
Yeah, I've seen episodes like that. I think it was the original series.
Understood, sir.
Good luck. Redrick out.
Lay in a course for Morassia, warp 5.
Oh, warp 8.
Yes, sir.
Engage.
Don't crash, I haven't saved. came back to me, thank you. Let's save. Oh god, it was so far away. I killed... You don't click these, you click these. That's the thing that keeps screwing me up.
Engage.
So now we just watch stars streak by for... Wish these people had more to say.
Warning. Entering nebula.
Any suggestions, number one?
Oh. We're entering a nebula.
I'm sorry, Captain. I don't have any suggestions right now.
Entering non-aligned space.
Helm, standard orbit.
Well, that was quick. We're here. Nice.
Captain's log supplemental. The Enterprise has arrived at Morassia to investigate the disappearance of Dr. V. Humforsch, an exobiologist stationed here for the past 2 years.
Humforsch?
The three species native to this world have enjoyed a millennium of peaceful cooperation, and this visit will give us the opportunity to review Morassia's petition for membership in the Federation.
Sounds intriguing.
It's time we introduced ourselves. Mr. Worf, Hail Constable Lixie.
Lixie.
Aye, Captain.
Yeah, get Licky on the horn, will you?
I'm Captain Jean-Luc Picard of the Federation Starship Enterprise. We have come to investigate the disappearance of Dr. Humforsch.
I don't want that licking me, Lixie.
Welcome to Morassia. As I told Admiral Redrick, I really don't think Dr. Humforsch is in any danger. She's probably on an extended field trip.
Looks like that and talks like the Queen of England.
Good. We'll need your beam-down coordinates.
Well, when the Queen of England was a lot younger.
I shall transmit them. And, Captain, in order to protect the animals in the preserve, we permit no weapons of any kind on the surface.
What? That is inexcusable.
Our away teams carry phasers for self-defense only. They can be locked on a low stun setting. I assure you none of your animals will be harmed.
Let me guess, the animals are like humans.
I'm sorry, Captain. I won't allow it. We cannot predict how even your lowest setting will affect our animals.
In that case, this is war. Worf, lock on the photon torpedoes. We'll respect your laws, etc.
We will respect your laws. The away team will not be armed.
For a male, you are unusually cooperative.
Thanks.
Is there any better way to begin a relationship?
Oh, he wants a relationship.
Forgive me, Captain. I am not accustomed to seeing a male in command.
Yeah. Better get used to it, baby.
I will await your investigators.
Okay. Before we beam down, any thoughts?
Any suggestions, number one?
I'm sorry, Captain, I don't have...
Oh god, they never have anything to
Mr.
say.
Mr. Data, any suggestions?
I suggest...
Counselor, do you have any...
I'm sorry, Captain.
They should at least say different random things.
Mr. Worf, your analysis.
Captain.
There's no need to check the orders from Starfleet. Let's go to the holodeck. Oh. What did I say holodeck? And I even chose holodeck. Transporter room. I'm tired. Captain needs a nap. Transporter. So automatically choosing Data, Worf, Troy, and...
Beam down coordinates selected.
Dr. Crusher. Can we bring more stuff? How do we get into, like, bring more stuff? I don't know. Don't know how. I guess the equipment might be on this side, if there were any. Alright, energize. I just like saying energize. Oh, hello.
Visitors for Constable Lixie. Constable Lixie is present.
Cool. Data is going over.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Data of the Starship Enterprise. I'm investigating the absence of Dr. Hoon Forsch.
What do you do, poker?
Welcome. So you are the artificial human. Interesting. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but there really is no need for alarm. Dr. Hoon Forsch is probably just on an extended field trip.
We'll see that for ourselves. Yeah, let's be diplomatic and give compliments and such.
The preserve clearly embodies your philosophy of life forms living within life forms to create a single harmonious organism. It is an impressive achievement.
Life forms living within life forms?
Very observant, Commander. Your perceptiveness does you credit.
Who were the last people to see the doctor?
Who were the last people to see the doctor?
Apparently, Consultant Idia was the last to see her. They had dinner or some such. It's all in my report. You should be able to access it through your tricorder.
Okay. If the doctor had been injured, yeah.
If the doctor had been injured somewhere in the preserve, would you be able to locate her?
Of course. But our surveillance system can detect signs of distress in any of our inhabitants. And we've had no sign of trouble from the doctor.
Unless she's just completely unconscious? I don't know why I would say that. Thank you for your time.
Thank you for your time.
Oh, he's analyzing. I'm like, we didn't bring phasers. What's he pointing? Tricorder. Oh, wait. Look at tricorder, right? Well, Dr. Hun Forsch, I'm saying it right, is a female, so that works in her favor in this case. Federation Exobiologist. Morphology Institute. Duty: enter local species in Federation Morphology Database. Advise, preserve caretakers. Customs check. Short-term visitors to Morassia must declare possessions. Missing: backpack gear, 4 field suits, hygiene kit, bioprobe, cryostabilizer kit, and fieldwork boots. Surveillance: no distress calls recorded. Fieldwork renders nearly all the doctor's colleagues inaccessible. Last sighting was by Dr. Idia, listed last. Oh, here's other people. Listener M. Bandaka Enango, permanent resident, Federal Animal Communication Specialist, Visual Communication, discussed preserve animals. And we've got Tiller A. Mavit, short-term resident, Federation Phytosociologist, hailing contact, discuss preserve species in relation to plant community. Healer Zolas, permanent resident, Euclidean neurologist, visual contact, discuss preserve and its caretaking. Consultant Idia, short-term resident, Federation recommendation, exobiologist, preserve consultant, last visual contact, discuss preserve and native species. And finally, mission objective, location, Morassia Preserve, locate Dr. V. Hunforsch. Morassia is a candidate for Federation entry. The preserve is managed by Constable Lixie, who opposes Morassia's Federation membership petition. Oh, she does, huh? The doctor is a Federation exobiologist posted to Morassia to catalog new species for the Federation Morphology Database. She has failed to report in on schedule. Cultural note, Morassian society is strictly matriarchal. Males are second-class citizens at best. At best, huh? Let's save. And let's save.
Intriguing.
Intriguing? What, saving?
Constable Lixie is a Morassian of the Euclidean species. She oversees the preserve and reports directly to the planetary government. The computer is a BAT-4003, an obsolete Milosian model. It has been modified for hand and foot operation.
I have no idea what Milosians are.
The computer is a bat.
Okay, so this whole thing is one, okay. Braiding?
The braiding is woven from stone and hair, traditionally taken from the Euclidean tribal matriarch after her death. Intriguing.
Intriguing. It's nice to have data along. Branch carvings.
The carvings are signatures of all past inhabitants of these quarters.
Veranda bird?
Verandas are highly intelligent avian mammals with sophisticated vocal abilities.
Yeah, before it was talking just like a person, now it's just making bird sounds, though. Doorway?
Intriguing.
The doorway is intriguing.
Lieutenant Worf is the ship's chief security officer. Commander Troy is the ship's counselor. Dr. Beverly Crusher is the Enterprise's chief medical officer.
Indeed. Anything else to look at? Branch carvings, window. Oh, basket. Yeah, I was looking at this thing. This is a skeleton rib cage with something in it.
This basket holds fruit, roots, and larvae for the constable's Veranda bird. Morassians typically use the bones of the dead to make useful objects.
Fruit, roots, and larvae. Something doesn't belong here. Alright, let's have everyone look around at everything.
Lieutenant Commander Data is in charge of operations for the Enterprise. Counselor Troy is the ship's counselor.
You've heard him talk about Crusher.
Constable Lixie oversees the preserve. She would make a formidable opponent.
Doesn't Worf usually say formidable? I thought he did.
The computer is a Milosian model. These carvings appear to be decorative. A pattern of gemstones has been woven into the fur. This is a food basket. Nice design.
Nice design.
It is an excellent vantage point for overseeing the preserve. It is an impressive animal.
Well, I don't think I missed anything.
These carvings appear to be decorative.
Alright, let's switch to... let's have Crusher look around.
Deanna is the ship's counselor. Lieutenant Commander Data is in charge of operations for the Enterprise. Constable Lixie is in charge of the preserve.
Indeed.
It's a computer.
It's a computer. I don't give a crap about it. It's a computer.
Morassia has some interesting local artwork. An intricate weave. It looks like hair or fur. With some semi-precious stones. There's nothing unusual here.
This is unusual.
The basket is made out of a skeleton. Quite an impressive watchdog. There's nothing unusual here.
Do we have Worf look at the animal?
It is an impressive animal.
Yeah.
We did not come here for sightseeing.
Gotta sightsee everything while you're here.
Worf is the ship's security chief. Beverly is the chief medical officer. It's Lieutenant Commander Data.
Sure is.
Constable Lixie is in charge of the preserve. She seems to be suspicious of us. This is the constable's computer. It's some kind of animal hair or fur with gemstones woven into it. The Morassians certainly have some beautiful art forms.
Is this beautiful as well?
The boot's probably for the bird creature.
Yeah. The bird creature.
The constable has a wonderful view of the preserve. What a beautiful bird.
Well, what else can I do? See what everyone has to say.
Visitors for Constable Lixie. Constable Lixie is present.
I met... Okay. The other people. But she can't talk to herself, so...
We should search for Dr. Hoonforce's lab.
I'd like to learn more about the doctor's research. Let's take a look at her lab.
Why is she walking over to
the doctor's disappearance may be related to her research. Perhaps we should examine her laboratory. Thank you for your time.
Talk to this bird thingy?
Visitors for Constable Lixie.
Bird doesn't say anything different.
Visitors for Constable Lixie.
I thank you for your time.
Should I ask that other question?
Visitors for Constable...
Let's have her ask. You don't like the doctor very much, do you?
You don't like the doctor very much, do you?
She hasn't made many friends here. She disagrees openly with our philosophy, our methods, and has even accused us of smuggling banned species.
Making waves, huh? Like to examine the preserved grounds. Where she was last working, since she won't say it.
We'd prefer to limit the number of outsiders in the preserve while it is under construction. Investigating the doctor's laboratory should be sufficient.
It's important that we retrace the doctor's steps exactly. And besides, the Federation has requested an update on Morassia for your membership petition. If you let us into the preserve, we can make a more detailed report.
The Federation's requests are not law here. Not yet. But in the interests of cooperation, I'll open up the area surrounding my outpost. Be sure to stay within the visitors' areas. You must understand, my responsibility to the animals comes first.
Yeah.
I'd like to see the doctor's quarters.
Of course. Her laboratory quarters are at the end of the path towards the mountains.
Has anyone heard from Dr. Hoonforce?
No, I'm afraid not.
Beverly?
Excuse me, Constable. Has there been any contact with Dr. Hoonforce yet?
No, I'm afraid not.
Well, we analyze this computer.
The computer is a BAT 4003, and
nothing new, huh? Med tricorder?
I see no way of using this with that object.
Well, when in the original games, the 25th anniversary in Judgment Rights, McCoy would tell us information about life forms. I guess we don't do that.
Verandas are highly intelligent avian mammals with sophisticated vocal abilities.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna sign off here. Thanks for watching, guys, and join me next time for when I explore more of this area. Get into the preserve and the laboratory and all that fun stuff. Endure. And enduring, grow strong.